What's up, sneaker fam? Friday, August the 10th, 2012. Back with another at Kitchen Talk 12 on retro releases after 2007. Shout out to the crew, the commission with Young Dr. Seuss, Top Shelf Sneaker, and myself. Shout out to Complex Magazine for placing my collection on 25 insane sneaker collections list, and they posted it online, so a big shout out to them. I appreciate that a lot. And the first question, first part of this video, is on a question by Nuke Mechanic, and he wanted to know, and several other people wanted to know, how did I end up a Bulls fan and not a Pistons fan? I was born and raised in Ann Arbor, which is west of here in Detroit, so I wasn't born in or raised in Detroit. I moved to Detroit in 1995 after I moved back from California, but I was a Jordan fan since college back in 1981, so, you know, it was pretty simple. Once he went to the Bulls, there I was, a Bulls fan. I was never really a Pistons fan. You know, I never really liked the Pistons. So, not until 2004 when they beat the Lakers. You know, I'm not a Lakers fan. So, you know, I really wanted the Pistons to win in. And plus, Chauncey Billups was probably my favorite Piston ever. You know, so I was rooting for the Pistons to win the NBA Finals in 2004. You know, I really didn't like the brand of ball the Pistons played. And plus, I liked MJ's flair, his fire, his desire. And I was just, you know, I was a Bulls fan, you know. And when they finally beat the Pistons and how they walked off the floor and didn't shake the Bulls' hands, you know, I just, you know, thought that that was kind of classless. You know, it's like passing the torch. You know, they beat them for so many years. And then Mike finally got the guys together. Scotty got rid of his migraines, and, you know, Horace started stepping up. Bill Cartwright got his game popping, you know, Will Perdue and Tony Kukoc, Craig Hodges, John Paxson, go on and on and on. Then the Bulls, you know, started doing their thing, and the rest was history. So, and basically, to answer the question, I was just a Jordan fan since he was in college. You know, we were born the same year, in college the same year, except he left 2 years early. So, you know, I was just an MJ fan, period. So that's pretty much the answer to that question. Now, we're going to jump on to the topic today. This is just a discussion video, like I say before. Please keep your comments appropriate. You know, I know some things might be discussed that you might not agree with, you might not like. You might not like other comments that other people on our page make, but be respectful of everyone on the page. Now, we're going to talk about retro releases after 2007. That's when I believe the quality took a shift into negative, into the negative direction. You know, 2008, they came with the countdown packages, and not many of them had that good of quality shoes in the packages. Then also in 2008, they came with the Fusions, where the Air Force Ones and the Jordans combined to make a shoe. Now, this particular shoe right here, called the Gray Nurse, this is one of the better Fusions. And you can look at the quality of the material. And I know some people may not agree with me, but you look at this material on this particular shoe, it's on the lines of the material on the bends. Now, I'm not saying that all of the Fusions are nice looking shoes, but some of them deserve respect. And that's definitely one of them. And you can look at the Nubuck on here. extra soft. The leather on here is A1. And yes, I reversed the straps. This one here is showing the new buck. And this one here is showing the mesh on there. You can see how A1 the leather is on that particular shoe. So I had no problems with that shoe at all. Now, we're going to jump to the 1999. Still had the Nike Air on the back of the Cement 4. And we're going to roll with the 2012. Now, people want to try to stock these shoes. Okay? In my opinion, you try to stock these shoes for 10 to 12 years, I don't think they're going to last as long as you trying to stock the older model Jordan shoes, basically because of the materials used. I really don't think this shoe can really stand up to a lot of wear compared to a lot of wear in this shoe. And, you know, the air bubble is still clear, still rockable, still has the Nike Air on the inside. This shoe is still in excellent shape. Look at the leather, how soft it is. And then you compare it to this one here and look at how hard that is. And for people to try to stock this shoe or try to leave it DS, and this is already a harder type leather, and the way people are putting them in the Ziploc baggies and just leaving them in the boxes, this shoe is just going to crumble before 8, 9, 10 years down the road. Now, this is just my opinion on this. I don't understand why people will double up and pay double for this shoe, and you can get an older model shoe for less. That's a much better quality shoe, and that you can still wear. I can still wear that particular shoe. I just can't see myself paying over retail for a recent release of a retro shoe. I'd rather put my money towards an older model shoe, towards a Ben, towards a Grape 5 or something like that. Now, I just recently got a Grape 5 in. It had been DS since 2006, 6 years. And I immediately took it straight to the foot game because I believe in wearing my shoes. So that's why, you know, I buy my shoes pretty much, is to wear them. I mean, if you leave them in the box, they're going to crumble. Then you try to bring them out X amount of years later, and they're not going to be any good. And the point with that is, you try to do that with these and hold on to these for 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years, meaning the recent release shoes, I just don't think they're going to last that long. You know, without you really seeing that the quality used isn't going to last as long as the quality that was used in the older model shoes. Just let me know what you think. That's my thoughts on it. That, you know, I'm not complaining about the quality. The quality is what it is. But I'm just asking a question on, for people that are stocking the newer retros, what do you think is going to happen with your shoes in 5, 6, 7, 8, maybe 10 years later, and some shoes 15 years later to 18 years later? Do you think that they're still going to be the same? Do you think the material is going to break down faster than the older model shoes? So that's pretty much my question of today. Once again, big shout out to Nuke Mechanic. Thank you for asking that question. Then we got another trade here with Dwight Howard going to the Lakers. So, you know, it's going to make the NBA real interesting once again for the next season coming up. But what was Orlando thinking? You know, I mean, you know, and it's obvious that that's where Dwight Howard wanted to go. His significant other is living in L.A. He's been living in L.A. And he's been rehabbing in L.A., you know, once he had his back surgery. But the funny thing about it is he went to a Dodgers game. They booed him. But once they found out he signed with the Lakers, most likely the people that booed him are now cheering him and will have on a number 12 jersey. It's crazy how sports fans can be, you know, 1 minute they with you, 1 minute they against you, or 1 minute they're against you, and the next minute they're with you. So we'll see. It'd be an interesting season. I'm still a Celtics fan, so, you know, I know we got some work to go, but we weren't supposed to go as far as we did last year, you know, and like Herm Edwards says, that's why we play the game. Written on paper, who does it look like to you? Yeah, the Lakers and Miami. OKC is right there also, but, you know, with Dwight Howard, everybody's pretty much giving it to the Lakers, and then you know that Miami is the beast of the East right now. So, you know, if they're looking at that Kobe-LeBron finals matchup already, and the season hasn't started. But we still got to play the game. Injuries and whatnot will definitely come into play with some teams, but looking forward to another great season. Go Celtics. You know I'm still rolling with you, win or lose. You know, I'm not switching teams, none of that. The morning word: whenever you are confronted with ignorance, conquer that ignorance with just the opposite. They need love and prayer, if you know what I mean. It's your boy Jumpman, fading to the back from the basement of the Jays. Let me know what you think about this particular fusion, this quality and material, if you've seen it, if you have it, compared to the material on the bin. I'm not saying it's exactly the same, but I'm saying that the quality on this shoe is pretty doggone close on this particular shoe, the Gray Nurse. I'll holler at you later. Peace.